Welcome to lesson on comparing measurements given in metric units. In the first example, if a person's pupillary distance, which is the distance from one pupil to the other, is 61 millimeters, and the distance from their pupil to the middle of their upper lip is 7 centimeters, which distance is longer? To answer this question, we need to compare the distances of 61 millimeters and 7 centimeters. And therefore, we need to convert 61 millimeters to centimeters or convert 7 centimeters to millimeters. For this example, we will convert 7 centimeters to millimeters. We will perform the conversion using a unit fraction. So we first write 7 centimeters as a fraction with a denominator of 1. And now we multiply by a unit fraction that will convert centimeters to millimeters. Looking at the conversions below, we will use the conversion 1 centimeter equals 10 millimeters to form the unit fraction. Because you want centimeters to simplify out of this product, the units of centimeters must be in the denominator of the unit fraction, leaving millimeters for the numerator. Now using the conversion 1 centimeter equals 10 millimeters, the unit fraction is 10 millimeters divided by 1 centimeter. This fraction is equal to 1, so we are not changing the value, we are changing the units by multiplying by this fraction. Notice the units of centimeters simplify to 1, leaving us with the product of 7 times 10 millimeters, or 70 millimeters. Because 7 centimeters equals 70 millimeters, we answer the question by comparing 61 millimeters to 70 millimeters. Well, because 61 millimeters is less than 70 millimeters, we now know that 61 millimeters is less than 7 centimeters. And therefore, 7 centimeters is the longer distance. When giving the answer, we give the distance using its original units. And therefore, we say the distance of 7 centimeters is longer than 61 millimeters. Let's look at the second question. One doctor purchased 2,000 individual 2.5 gram doses of medication. Another doctor purchased 4.5 kilograms of the same medication. Which amount is more? To answer this question, we need to compare 2,000 2.5 gram doses to 4.5 kilograms. Well, 2,000 individual 2.5 gram doses would be 2,000 times 2.5 grams. We want to compare this amount to 4.5 kilograms. Well, 2,000 times 2.5 is 5,000, which means we compare 5,000 grams to 4.5 kilograms. And therefore, we need to convert 5,000 grams to kilograms or 4.5 kilograms to grams. For this example, we will convert 5,000 grams to kilograms using a unit fraction. Beginning with 5,000 grams as a fraction, with the denominator of 1, we multiply by a unit fraction that will convert grams to kilograms. Looking at the conversions, 1 kilogram is equal to 1,000 grams. We will use this conversion to form the unit fraction. We want grams to simplify out of this product, and therefore grams must be in the denominator of the unit fraction, leaving kilograms for the numerator. The conversion is 1 kilogram equals 1,000 grams, and therefore the unit fraction is 1 kilogram divided by 1,000 grams. The units of grams simplify to 1. The product gives us 5,000 divided by 1,000 kilograms. 5,000 divided by 1,000 is 5, and therefore 5,000 grams equals 5 kilograms. So to compare 5,000 grams and 4.5 kilograms, we now compare 5 kilograms to 4.5 kilograms. Well, 5 kilograms is greater than 4.5 kilograms, and therefore 5,000 grams is greater than 4.5 kilograms. And now we know 2,000 doses of 2.5 grams is greater than 4.5 kilograms. So we'll state 2,000 individual 2.5 gram doses is more than 4.5 kilograms of the same medication. I hope you found this helpful.